So I think that's when we have to start changing, you know, including me, about how I think and what we do and what we put out into the universe and the atmosphere and all these vibes we create around ourselves and our situations and the people that are close to us. I want to create or cultivate an environment for us ladies, like ladies who look like us. I ain't gonna say minority, black women, to get together and do something positive. That was the whole purpose behind this vision board thing, or one of the purposes. So I worked with Aquila. I was like, you know what? This time I met you, I'm not gonna be doing this. Like, I'm not gonna be doing this. I'm gonna take Diva, which is the organization we started, and made it into a non-for-profit organization. I was like, I'm gonna take Diva, and I'm gonna take it outside of the schools, and I'm taking it into the community, and that's what I'm gonna do. That basically is the backstory behind me doing this vision board. But then Nicola had a bright idea and said, hey, why don't we put the vision board in the mirror? I was like, what? Genius. Three, you know, important things to me is staying focused and to be kind. That's very important. Even when people aren't kind to you, like relentlessly kind, because I truly believe and I've seen that when you go out of your way to be so kind to people who are nasty to you, they can't help it but reciprocate that gesture. So, and be awesome. Like, and we need to know that we're awesome. Like I said, healing with kindness is a huge thing for me. Women on a mission, that's huge for me. We're all women. We all need to have an established mission. If you don't know where you're going, you're lost. Like, you need to have somewhere you're going, a final destination. Determined individuals, visualizing academic success. And those, we mentor young ladies in grades 7 to 10, we meet every week. And we have curriculum for them, we have secrets for them, we try to expose them to post-secondary education. We want them to know all of their choices, college, certification, path, anything. Just you need to make some money. You'll really need time. Queens don't queen, which is something that's near and dear to my heart. If it wasn't bad for adversity, there would not be a queen on queen. So I feel like I'm a prime example of you need struggle, you need adversity, you need all of those things that come your way, you need them. Like, it's absolutely necessary for growth. I'm teaching my kids, you go to school, you graduate, you get that degree, and you're gonna come bring it back to the business that you're here to build. Because you're going to grow your people and then you're going to hire your people and then you're going to circulate that black dot. A CEO, because that's what I am, that's what I am to be, and a true leader. And then, like I said, here is just because I want to see myself in like everything that I do in your future. Right? See yourself. And, you know, put on a mirror so you can hang it up in your house again.
Only sometimes your vision changes. So you may have something, you may want this kind of house one day, you may want this kind of car, you may want this career, and it changes so you can just reposition your vision and just take this off and put something on the phone. So that's why we use that force because it's easy to change. Okay. Instead of making a whole new board.
Everything that I said I wanted to do, I did it. And it just literally was me envisioning what I wanted to do and just doing it and going for it. Everything that I question, everything that I say I can't do or I'm not sure about doing, I do it and I pursue it relentlessly. Not even knowing how I'm gonna do it. We didn't know how we was gonna start the program. We didn't know how we were gonna be able to house these meetings. We didn't know how we were going to be able to have time for these meetings. We just didn't know any of that. What we did know is that there was a need for our program and that we had such a strong repertoire with these girls that we couldn't just let them down and leave them at school. So we felt compelled to do that. And that's just what we did. We just went for it and we did it. And I think that's what I want to empower everybody here and everybody else. That's what Queens Don't Queen is about. It's just empowerment. When me and the queen get together, 9 times out of 10, we talk about ideas. Always. All to the point where I got a notebook and I'm continuously taking notes because we're 9 times out of 10, we're always talking about ideas. We're all about just talking about how we can improve each other and ourselves and, you know, what we can do to help each other out, and we're always there for each other. And I just want to cultivate a bigger following in that